who should be here. Good morning. Welcome to the Northampton College virtual event. My name is Phil O'Hara. I'm Vice Principal for Curriculum and Student Progress at the College. And we're absolutely delighted that you're able to join us for the for this event today. Before we go on any further, probably best if I just explain how this all worked today. So in a moment, we're just going to get a short introduction from our principal, Pat Brennan Barrett, and our deputy principal, Patrick Levy. And they're just going to give us a quick overview of the college and an update on the current situation. Then you'll hear from our expert panelists in the room, and they're going to be talking about the opportunities at the college, what it's like to study at Northampton College, and what knowledge and skills that you'll develop during your time with us and your progression opportunities. You'll also hear about what type and range of support is available through the college. So that's really the information you're going to get. If you see at the bottom of your screen, there's a little Q&A icon. That's an opportunity for you as we go through. If you open that box up, you'll have an opportunity to add some questions to our panel of experts, and they'll be replying through some of our presentations. And as well as that, there'll be an opportunity for questions and answers at the end of the session. So we'll pick up anything that comes to light across this next hour or so, and we'll get some answers to you as we go through as well. So that's the plan for the next hour or so. So technology permitting, and we haven't had any issues that we haven't been able to solve over the last week. So it's all gone well. So hopefully the technology will hold up. So if we just can play the introduction, please, colleagues.
Welcome to our first virtual open event. My name is Pat Brennan Barrett, and I'm the principal of Northampton College.
And I'm Patrick Levy, and I'm the deputy principal at Northampton College.
And we hope that we're going to be able to give you the information that you need to make your choice. But before we move on to that, I'd like to talk to you about the pandemic and the preparations that we're making to make you safe at the college. So we've taken very good heed of the government advice, and we've gone further. We've mapped every part of our college, all the rooms. We're looking to find a footfall reduction of 50%. We will make sure that there is social distancing in all of the classrooms. We will have zoned areas, and we will have sanitizers and PPE. This is very important for your safety, and you will be expected to change your behaviour, but we'll help you to do that. We know how important it is for you to feel safe coming to college. We have made significant investments in technology through cameras and laptops, and we are moving very much towards the digital age, but you will spend significant amounts of time in college. And as we go through this presentation, I hope that all of your questions will be answered. And Mr. Levy will talk again about our COVID response some way through the presentation. So I'd like to direct you now to our presentation. We are one of the leading colleges in the country. We're actually now seventh for the national league tables for the 16 to 18 curriculum. So that's significantly improved over years. And this is down to our students and our staff and how we work with students. We're also ranked 13th and 18th for English and Maths and 4th for ESOL. We want to make sure that you're in a college that can give you the very best. So we are a good college with outstanding features. We've got very, very good confidence in our delivery, and we know that we can get you to be the best you can be, set your expectations high, and help you to achieve them. So 96% of our students have passed their qualification last year. We expect that to be higher this year, even with the challenges of the pandemic. So together with a very outstanding environment and a culture of very high expectations, you'll be immersed in a state-of-the-art building. All of our buildings are state-of-the-art, both at Daventry, Booth Lane and Lower Mounts. 94% of our students go on to further education, work or apprenticeships. That's a very high number progressing towards their goals. We aspire to support a generation of students who believe that they can make a difference. Look at the challenge and find a solution. Succeed in changing the world. Embrace modern technologies. Build new companies and create new jobs not yet imagined, especially now when we need you most.
So now I'm going to take you through some of the specific areas of study within the college. Every student in the college is an individual, and the programmes are essentially made up of a main qualification for students who need maths. There will be maths study, English for effective communication, digital skills to help you in the digital world, where appropriate and safe, work experience will be offered. All students will have individualised targets, and you'll have tutorials to support you through your progress. We offer qualifications at a full range of levels, from foundation and entry level right through to level 5. Where you start within the college depends on your prior attainment and the qualifications that you come to us with, but there is an opportunity for every applicant. The college prides itself on how supportive it is to its students. We're very conscious of providing wraparound care, so a student will get a timetable and will not just be expected to attend face-to-face lessons and perhaps online lessons, but also to embrace the wraparound care that supports their learning. As previously mentioned, we're very conscious of providing a safe educational environment, and our response to the COVID pandemic has been to really interrogate how we make the environment safe, how we produce a blended learning delivery model that is safe and will secure progression for all students. Social distancing, hygiene and protective equipment will all be very important for students coming to this college. I mentioned wraparound support, and that support is critical to help students in their progress. Lessons will be interactive through various digital platforms. A wide range of online learning resources will be made available, and all students will have help to develop their digital skills to ensure that they can capitalise on the learning opportunities here at Northampton College. We will provide support for providing students with the equipment and the resources that they need to ensure that they do well on their programmes of study. Our expectations are very high. The college has a very good reputation. That reputation is built upon good habits for students, habits that develop excellent punctuality, excellent attendance to all lessons, dedication and positive engagement, high aspiration to achieve the best possible grades within programmes, and we provide a very effective monitoring and tracking process to ensure students know the progress they are making. Our journey to outstanding. We endeavour to be the best college in the community, putting our students at the heart of everything we do. We're constantly evolving and challenging ourselves. We're building a college to meet the needs of future generations. And to meet the needs of an environmentally sustainable society. Join us on our journey to outstanding and unlock your potential.
Well, that gives you a real understanding of where the college is coming from at this time. My name's Bev Davis, and I'm delighted to meet all of you here virtually. Thank you so much for coming. I'm now going to introduce some key colleagues who work alongside me, as I'm the assistant principal who heads up supported learning. They're part of the key team in the college. So Mel McLean is our supported learning manager, and Steph Holly, who's also on the panel, is the supported learning coordinator. We've also got Thomas Goodrich, who's our learning support manager, and Rhiannon Hancock, one of the practitioners who works in Thomas's team. She focuses on hearing impairment and was doing the signing in our principal's video there. We've also got Emma Attree from Student Services, who can answer any questions around student finance, around the support we offer across the college to all of our students. And we've also got some colleagues from marketing who've put this session together for us, Victoria Murphy and Alex. You might be answering some of your questions through the session. First of all, we'd like to show you around the college, and then we'll tell you a little bit more about our courses, what we can offer you, and the support we can put in place to help you achieve your goals. So let's have a look at our virtual tour. Giving you a picture of what college looks like. But a quick reminder before we go on, do remember we've got a question and answer feature on Zoom, and do feel free to ask any questions that come to mind throughout what I tell you about. And then I'm going to hand over to my colleague Mel. She'll talk to you a little bit as well. We've also got a video that follows at the end. So if anything comes to mind that you'd like to ask us, do just type your question in, and then one of us will get back to you through the course of the rest of the session. You might find it's a question that perhaps needs a private answer, and our colleagues are aware of that, and they'll be able to message you back just to you. So, coming to college, you've seen what college looks like, and it is all about planning your future and enabling you, inspiring you to make the most of the opportunities we can offer. We'll look to at how we support you to do that. So we all really, in supported learning, we all are all about inspiration and your aspiration. So could we have the next slide, please? One really important thing that I need to let you know about is that all of our students last year passed their qualifications, and all of our students moved on to what we call positive destinations. What does that mean? It means further study. It means work and training. We have a number of students who've gone on to supported internships and traineeships. And the courses that we offer you are going to give you the skills you need to be able to do this. We've had students who've gone on to IT courses, to media courses, to performing arts courses, for example, to catering courses. So they're all possibilities for you. Now, if we could have a look at the next slide, you'll see that Ofsted visited us not so long ago. You'll have heard of Ofsted. They visit every college every 4 or 5 years and make some judgments about the work we do. Pat, our principal, told us that our college is good with outstanding features. And the work we do with students like you, students with additional support needs, was graded as absolutely outstanding by Ofsted. They visited us about a year and a half ago now. And the next slide will show us exactly what they thought of the work we did. You can see here that they picked up exceptional progress with independent living skills and how students achieve their qualifications. They picked up the inclusive learning environment. They've picked up all the advice and guidance we give students in a format that's right for you. So students then moving on to higher levels, to employment. We have had some of our high need students from other parts of the college go on to apprenticeships as well. Supported learning students have certainly moved on to traineeships and supported internships. And that last point, the point in orange, just picks up some of the targets that we set. We find out in great detail where you're at, and then we set you the steps you need to get where you can be, where you can get to. So this is why we think that our course offer is going to be right for you. And we've got a number of pathways that I'm going to ask Mel McLean now to talk you through. Mel, handing over to you.
Thanks, Bev. Okay, just to reiterate, welcome to our area of supported learning. I'm Mel. It's my pleasure today to talk you through some of the programmes and some of the groups and the courses programmes we offer. So we start with stepping in, and stepping in is really your introduction to college. So it's how we help and support you to transition from your present education, and how we make sure we pick up all the support needs, all the other additional resources you may or may not need, and how we help you do that in a way that you're motivated and happy to come into college. So those programmes might consist of specialist programmes in terms of our Moving On programme, which we work with the National Autistic Society on. It might also be around an area of interest that you have. It might also be that we look at your levels and we look to where you want to get to. So part of our other programme offer is Stepping Up, and that's part of the skills development. And that's where we really begin to explore what skills you have, what skills that you would like to have, what you might need in terms of career aspirations or a job or interests. And then we look at how we support you with our resources, with our teaching, and with the rest of the college support, along with Emma and her team and Thomas and his team. So then we move through to our stepping out area, and that's really where we're really starting to think about how are you going to transition out of college, where are you going to transition to, and how we begin to prepare you for that. So that's quite a way ahead, I appreciate, from where you might be entering into, but I think it's really important to mention that as well at this point. So how do we do this? So we really start on the basis of which course is right for you. And we do that by gathering all the information that we already have for you, that you have for you. We talk to you. We may talk to your parents and carers. We may even talk to your present education setting. But we do that all with you. You're at the centre of this. This is about you, the student. So can we move on to the next one? Okay. So what's the difference? So we are in a bigger learning environment. It is part of what we move to in terms of your student community. There are lots of great opportunities for you to be part of any aspect of college that you would like to be. And ultimately, as I think Patrick's mentioned, and our principal Pat, and Phil, and Bev, it's all about getting you ready for who you want to and who you can be. Are we moving on to the next one? Okay, so you're going to hear this term quite a lot. It's called a study programme. And actually, I'm going to talk you through what that consists of. So when we refer to a study programme, we're really talking about what's in your timetable. what are you likely to be doing at college? What's your day going to look like? And really, it's going to look a lot like this. So it's maths and English, and we might start at functional skills. We might start with our Ascentis stepping stone program. We may even start with GCSE. And quite a lot of that will depend on what qualifications you've already achieved, where you'd like to be, where are your strengths? And that's what we really want to build on. That's the real important message here, that we build on your strengths. And then we look at a vocational qualification. And by vocational, we mean, how do we start to prepare you for life and work and those skills involved in that, which are independence, resilience, self-esteem, confidence, all of those skills encompassed in how do you deal with different situations? What might the demands be of a job or a different level of job? And we start to explore those. And we do that through, at the moment, through City and Guilds with a range of qualifications. I think Patrick did touch on work experience, and throughout the academic year, we will have opportunities of work experience, providing it's safe and we're permitted to do that in the environment we find ourselves in. But also we'll have some experiences of work. So we may invite some people in, we may get people to talk to you about chosen or different chosen ideas of a career, but all that will be in the area of world of work. And then each week you'll have a tutorial, and a tutorial is really your opportunity to talk to your personal tutor about how you think college is going, about what support you might need. That might involve somebody from Emma's team. It might also involve people and colleagues working within Thomas's team. But all of those supports mechanisms are there for you. Throughout the college year, we have some really fantastic enrichment opportunities, and your personal tutor and your course leader will talk to you about those as they come up throughout the college year. And then finally, we have digital skills, and many of you are probably better on computers than we are, in all honesty. But digital skills is another way of exploring your skills. It's another way of identifying the range of confident skills that you can take forward in your independent life and in your work life. So that's really our study programme. And what do you need to succeed? So that's kind of the million-dollar question, I think. Coming into college every day with a positive attitude isn't just something for a student, it's something for everybody that works within college. And I have to say, really proud to say, that Northampton College really does model that. Everybody here is here to support you, is here to support you in your endeavours, to move on, to motivate you towards your goals and to your aspirations. So it's really important to learn to ask for help when you need it, and sometimes we don't always know how to do that, and that's all, and around that is all about learning how to be independent, learning to be confident, to have self-esteem in your work. But crucially, we're going to be talking to you, we'll have an open dialogue with you about the support needs, about what you need as an individual to get on in college. And then making the most of opportunities at college, making new friends, exploring new activities, and really embracing being a college student. And think about what's next. We're always thinking about progression. We're always thinking about what's the next pathway. And actually, we're partners with you in that. And that's what I think supported learning really seeks to do, is to partner you in your aspirations, your progression, and your success. Thank you.
Around me, taking pages from a magazine, been looking for the answers ever since we were 17. You know the truth can be a weapon to fight this world of ill intentions. A new answer to the same question, how many times will you learn the same lesson? Just gotta hold on and on, 'cause we're gonna be legends, gonna get their attention. What we're doing here ain't just scary. we carry. It's about to be legendary. 'Cause we're gonna be legends. Gonna get their attention. What we're doing here ain't just scary. It's about to be legendary. Yeah, we're gonna be legends. Gonna teach them all a lesson. Got this feeling in our souls we carry. It's about to be legendary.
So that was our life-changing video. Hi, my name's Alex. I work in the marketing department at Northampton College. So that's a really nice overview of some real student success stories. People have come to college to study a full-time course and gone on to be really successful in their chosen careers. So I just wanted to show you that little video as an example of the sort of things that our students have gone on to do.
Thank you, Alex. We're now at the part of our event with you where we've got the opportunity to pick up some of your questions. Interestingly, while the video and while colleagues were talking, we were answering some questions that people had asked. One of those, very interestingly, was about the range of additional support needs that students have in our area. And we do work with students with hearing impairments, with visual impairments, with a range of processing conditions. Mel mentioned the work we do with students with autism, with the support of the National Autistic Society. So we have all of the additional support needs that you would expect students would come with. And we do meet and address those and work with those students very, very successfully. So we also had a question on the way about SEN transport, and through student services we work with the council and with transport providers to make sure you can get to college. That's really important. So if you've got any more questions now, please do feel free to ask them and we'll see what comes in. Now, just remember, we know that everybody's situation is really individual, and you might feel that this isn't the arena to ask your particular question. That's okay. There is an opportunity for questions now, but we're going to be in touch with you after the event as well, because we'll give you our contact details so we can continue this conversation from the event now and get back to you and arrange perhaps a one-to-one call, perhaps a separate virtual meeting if we need to, just to make sure you've got the opportunity to ask everything you want in the arena that's best for you. Have we got any questions coming in?
I think you guys have been very efficient and answered most of the questions, really. Bev, I think you've touched on transport, haven't you, and also the sort of accessibility. Can you just explain maybe a bit about the sort of day-to-day of the courses, how much time maybe they spend in college and how much time they get to do sort of different activities?
Absolutely. In fact, I think I'm going to hand this one over to my colleagues who are in the department. Mel, Steph, would you be able to answer this for us?
Sorry, Mel, I think you're still on mute.
Have I unmuted myself? Okay, so yes. The students will come in. They'll have some time to do a seat and settle. So they'll know what they're doing for the day. We generally do maths and English for 3 hours a week, which is topped up with the boost session. And then we will work on our vocational program. So they'll spend a certain amount of the day doing that as well. And they'll have a tutorial once a week with an academic coach. So the day-to-day, it's very structured. They know when their breaks are. They know, you know, they don't tend to change. So the students are aware what's happening now and what's happening next.
Can I add to that? Some information really around working with external partners, working on work skills, and some of the external projects that we've done in past years. Clearly, we're looking at what we can offer in the year ahead, but this will give you a picture of some of the things that we are able generally to do. we have a number of activities that students work on, don't we, Mel, around work skills. And I think you've got some plans in place to perhaps look at some enterprise skills with students.
I'll pick that up as well. So yeah, happily we've got lots of projects happening and some exciting project work with our B project. And so the hope is that students get involved in that, and we a more constructive kind of activity with bird boxes and other kind of, as you say, Bev, enterprise activities, but all of which is inclusive. There's a role for every student to take part and to be a part of that group as well.
Okay. Lovely, thanks very much for answering that question. I've had another question in from a participant asking, she says, I have a physical disability and dyslexia. Is there provisions for physical disabilities?
Absolutely. We work with students with a range of physical disabilities. Mm-hmm. The college buildings themselves are inclusive and are purpose-built for students with for students across the whole range of the community and the range of community needs. I think this year we have had 3 or 4 wheelchair users in our group of students. Obviously I don't know what the physical disability is here, but absolutely we can generally meet those needs and meet them very, very successfully. In terms of dyslexia, what I'd like to do is actually refer on to our additional learning support team here. Thomas, is there anything you'd like to add about dyslexia?
Hello, yes, of course. Yes, we do a very good provision here for students with dyslexia. We've got some specialist teachers that are qualified in specific learning difficulty, and we work very closely with Mel's team and can actually put together support packages for you. So that's something that we do for a lot of students across the college, and we'd be able to put something together especially for you.
Alex, I'd just like to add something about personal care here as well, because yes, that's something that young people and their parents where physical disability is concerned is often sort of in the background, a concern there. And I'd like to reassure people who are attending this event that we do offer personal care where that's appropriate in the college day, and we have fully trained and very, fully trained and all accredited personal care practitioners who work on an individual basis with students to make sure that needs are fully met and met appropriately.
Lovely, thanks very much, Bev. I think I've just got one more question come in asking about transportation. They're worried that they can't do anything about transport until they've accepted a place. Is that a problem, or you know, is it quite an easy fix once they've accepted their place?
It is a very straightforward process. I'm just going to refer to Emma in Student Services. Emma, I wonder if you could tell us a little bit more about that process.
Yeah, of course. I was literally just typing an answer. We don't need to wait until you've got your place in order for us to be able to post out the send transport application form. So I'll just send those details in the message here. It's a lady called Catherine Dan. She's the transport manager. So we can send out the transport application form for you now. We don't need to wait until you've got a place. Hopefully that answers the question.
Brilliant. Emma, if you could answer on the Q&A with a private message with your details, that'd be fantastic. Thank you very much. I think that's all the questions that we have today. So Bev, is there anything else you'd like to add before we pass back to Phil?
Oh, of course there's something I'd like to add, Alex. You know me too well. What I would like to add is just really to round up what everybody has said, and I hope participants and people who've attended the event will see that the whole programme of courses within supported learning pick up students' starting points, students' own individual situations, with that wraparound support to help students make the steps that they aspire to, and that again, just to reiterate that people have perhaps got questions that they don't feel they can ask here, and I'd really, really recommend they do follow up following the email that will come out with a recording of this event, so that people can watch it again, think of perhaps other questions that have come up, and then we'll have a contact email and a contact number in the information that comes out, and we'd love to keep the conversation going. We really would. So thanks, Alex.
Thanks very much, Bev. I think I spoke too soon because I actually just got two questions in as I said that. Thomas, I've got a question from a participant who's asked, is there someone I can speak to about starting college for people with anxiety? I have anxiety and wonder if there'll be someone to help.
Hi there. Yes, sorry, I was on mute. Of course, yes, we will talk to you about that when we start to talk to you about the course that you've chosen to do. And we're a very supportive college, and we've got a wide variety of different support services that are there for you. And we do have a wellbeing team that are particularly skilled at supporting people with anxiety. And so if that's something that you feel that you need, just let us know on your application form, or give us a call and let us know. I will private message you with my details. And we will be able to talk to you about that.
Fantastic. And one final question. When do we apply for a place at the college if we want to attend next year? I think, Bev, did you want to take that one?
I'll happily do that. As soon as possible, please, is the answer. Because we'd like to get to know you as soon as we can. And it's really important that we start finding out about you, about your own situation now, so that we can make sure we've got everything in place if you'd like to join us in September.
Fantastic, thanks very much. Okay, over to you, Phil, to close the event.
Okay, thank you very much. I think the panel and colleagues in the room have been really, really useful information that we've shared, and I don't think that they're quite shy, really, because what was mentioned earlier was that the college is good with outstanding features. The outstanding features is really the supported element is a big part of that. So they really should take credit for the great work that they do. So thank you to all our panelists, our expert panelists, and all our attendees for all of their really interesting questions. So some real insight and some detail that's been provided today. And what came across to me was about the opportunities for progression and the wraparound support, and really the getting ready for the next steps is really key to moving on. So I think that's come out for me really strongly. Hopefully the event you've found useful, and that's really giving you some information to make some informed decisions about your next steps and where you go. As colleagues mentioned, yeah, do get in touch with us as soon as possible. If you do need to get in touch with us, there is our email address, inquiries@northamptoncollege.ac.uk. So drop us a line there with any queries you've got. We'll come back to you. Yes, we would like your application as soon as possible. Any applications you make in the next few days will be fast-tracked so that we can contact you with any additional information and get that process started for you. And as Bev mentioned, we will be sending you out the link to this presentation and all of the information. So if you do want to watch anything again, then you know you can pick that up as well. So I think hopefully today's been useful, and we hope to see you back at the college after the summer break. And thank you very much for your time this morning. We hope you have a very good rest of the day and weekend, and stay safe, and hope to see you soon. Thank you.